laptops and we're studying and it's this great environment, but when we show up, this is what we get. It's pretty much a culture shock, is it not? Were they really being empathetic to our change in our lives, a critical time in our age and our culture, coming from different environments? Well, this is what we're dealing with when we're building these systems of technology, and I don't care what it is, if you're on the marketing side, if you're building a new product, a mobile app, this is the experience that we could be accidentally giving our customers. So what I hope to give for you today is something that you can take back not only to your jobs, to your companies, to your startups, but maybe even to your lives. It could even apply to something that's going on at your local church. First example that I'll give you, we have an older gentleman here that looks frustrated. Now, most of us in here in this room are probably of a little bit younger age. We're a little bit more technically inept. We build these great products, and we want to push them out to market. We want to push them out to our companies. This happened at the end of 2016, Amazon. They decided to publish or to sell, allow the sell of, an Indian flag that was on a doormat. Did anybody check with the Indian population to really see how that made them feel? It outraged them. It outraged them. It created a lot of static on the internet. But you want to know the sad part about it? About 3 months later, they placed Gandhi's face on a pair of flip-flops. Now, do you not think that Amazon has enough technological prowess to prevent something of this nature? But the question comes back to us as we're developing our products, as we're developing our services, are we keeping our end users in mind? Are we keeping the individuals who are consuming our content, who are using our interface in mind? Or are we just pushing out a product or a service based upon our own assumptions?